tonight on Access TV. Live live with Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Dean Edwards, Ashley Austin Morris, Mitch Fatel, Aaron Kleiber, and your host, Jim Breuer. From the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Jim Breuer.
Howdy, Gotham Comedy Club. Welcome to Access TV.
Some of you are like, where's that channel? Do we have that? Where is it?
You said it. I know, I have it. Because this is, whether you know it or not, this channel has like the greatest concerts ever. I've seen, a couple weeks ago, I saw Slash with his hat and the whole thing. And great concerts. I saw a Metallica on here. Yeah. Do you know Metallica? A little bit? Wow. Where are you from?
Australia.
Australia. No, Metallica, AC/DC. Do you know him? Angus Young? Yeah? Okay, good. All right, I'm gonna look at that. Yeah, I'm a hard rocker. I grew up a metalhead, a Long Islander. Yes? Metal? Yes. Metal! Yeah! Yeah, yeah, yeah! I like that music makes you like... Straight, you got that... Oh, I like that music. Go out and stare at wallabies. I'm a metalhead, which is weird because I'm 46 now, and I'm starting to realize that. The younger generation, such as yourself, just aren't, they're not into the metal. They're not into the Iron Maidens and the Ozzies. Ozzy? Yes? It's like a Wiggles for adults. But I realized, you know, I listen to that older music, like my sister's a lot older. She's in her 60s. And, you know, they listen to that bebop 50s music. And I realized as you grow up, that whatever music you have, that's the soul you have to your older. And I used to think that was so fruity. I'd look in the treetops.
That's my music.
Yeah, well, it's gone. But now I'm starting to realize, I think metal is that. It's like I'm starting to realize like hard rock and metal is gonna be oldies. When that's an oldies station, which at first I wasn't sure about. But now I'm like, you know what? Okay, embrace it. And if you're a metalhead like myself, you grew up with it, embrace it. I wanna be that old man. Or like dementia, you know, I'm not sure where I'm at, and my kids are taking me with the grandkids, and I'm stuck in a back seat just for a drive for the day. You know, I'm, like, I'm not sure where I'm at. Hey, where are we going?
Going for a ride, Grandpa.
Well, can you please turn on my music today?
Let's turn on Grandpa's music.
No, Mom, don't do that. The station sounds like they're sacrificing animals. Don't do it.
That's music. But how cool will that be to hear one day? It's just an old man. You're like, hey, you're listening to the oldies goldies station. Hard rock and heavy metal 24 hours a day. Oh, yeah. You want Pantera, Megadeth, Slayer? Guess what?
Slayer. Oh, that's scary, man. I saw a Slayer concert. That's the first time I feared my own race.
Slayer!
You know, I was just sitting in the back seat like, hey, if you grew up in the 80s and you turned an 80 this year, God bless you. Here's something to keep you alive one more day. This is Metallica's Creep of Death. You'd be in the back seat just, die, 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 I'm creeping dead. It'd be like sporadic old people in the backseat of cars listening to that station going, you son of a...
That's lyrics right there, creeping death. Your grandfather's creeping death, you know?
I see the way we treat our elderly. My mom's 86 now. She's blind in one eye. It's funny. It's all right. I mean, what are you going to do? Oh, man, she's blind. It's funny. You don't realize how funny it is to your kids. They don't know how to take it. They see Nana and they're like, oh, what's wrong with her face? Why is she looking all over?
Come here, I got some candy for you. Oh. Is that gonna happen to us?
Just go play and hide and seek with her. Just hide her left side. She'll never find you. Come on, ooh, Grandma. Oh, it's awful, man. You know, and the funniest part is she now lives in independent living. And I see that as... not that it's depressing, it's just different. You know, they're old and they got their records. Like, again, it made me think about getting older. I want to be that metal guy. And you're going to need metalheads in elderly homes. Because we're going to rock those places out.
Okay, all metalheads, please come to the rec room for the wheelchair mosh pit hour. Line it up, Freddy. Give me some Megadeth. Boy, that song really gets him going, don't it?
Mr. Breuer, let me help you. Don't you touch me. This is how we used to do it.
But, you know, that is the generation. I'm ready for it, man. AC/DC's fun. Dude, you got to get out. You got to see AC/DC. They have, what part of the story are you from?
Wagga Wagga.
What? Was that a racial comment? I mean, Wagga Wagga. All right, for Wooga Wooga to you, we're going to have a lot of fun tonight because we have a lot of great comics. You guys are a great crowd. We're at the best comedy club in New York City. And best, we are live on Access TV. Don't go anywhere.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Aaron Kleiber is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this comedian coming to stage, I've actually worked with him and I toured with him and I said, I want this guy to be on TV. So here he is on TV, Mr. Aaron Kleiber.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you guys are gorgeous. Look at you guys. Beautiful. Oh, I like it. Look at you guys, you little sweetie pies. Look at you. Oh, I love comedy. I love comedy clubs. Because it's perfect date night. Yeah, it is. It is. What are you married? And shut up. You don't get it. You don't understand. I'm a married dude. Where's all the married people? Look how excited. Look. Yeah, you see how excited they are? This is a special night, okay? This is. They're going to have sex with the lights on tonight. This is, guys. It's an important night, guys. They've been planning this for 4.5 months. You don't get it. I see a lot of young sweetie pies in here. You don't know nothing. Are you kidding me? We're all the daters, all you sweetie pie daters. Shut up. You guys still touching each other's privates? That's adorable. Still making out in the Target parking lot for no damn reason? Just kissing for no damn reason. It's not even your anniversary, and you're just kissing in the parking lot. What's the matter with you? Just go get your shower curtain, knock that shit off. You guys are idiots. It's not like all my young friends, they're like, oh, but you're married. You don't need to go anywhere. Oh, is that right, young people? Oh, yeah. Oh, because on a Friday night, me and my wife, we just light a clean cotton or a pine candle or whatever the hell those things, stupid $80 candles. You know what I'm talking about, you yuppie women. And then we put on our matching Japanese silk pajamas, right? That my wife ordered off of Amazon because she had a Shutterfly coupon, or I don't know about that stuff. And then we just pop in Dirty Dancing, yeah, on Blu-ray, ho! Then we just kiss each other on the neck for hours. Is that what you think what happens? Shit ain't like that. I'll tell you what, this is how it is right now. I see all you sweetie pies, I'll tell you how it is. Married 2 months, you guys, right? Oh, well, check this out, here's how it is. I'm on one couch by myself, okay? This is date night, all right? We got matching couches. I'm on my couch. I know which one is mine, too. It's one that's sagging like a son of a bitch, okay? My couch is a smile. It's a broken smile. And I'm on my couch. Guys, I'm drinking like a grown-up. I don't know what you guys got. I'm drinking like a grown-up. I have a whole box, a gallon of raspberry wine. That's what I'm doing. I got it on the back of the couch with 3 McDonald's straws into my mouth like a grown-up. Get with it. And I don't care what flavor it is, too. It was on sale. Kiwi, strawberry, watermelon. I don't care about nothing. I'll drink clearance wine under the cash register. It's dusty. You ever see the dusty wine? You're like, who drinks this dusty wine? I'll drink the shit out of dusty wine. I'm like, oh, it's $2.99 for a gallon. What is this? Blackberry pirate mustache. I don't care about it. I'll drink this all day. So I'm on my couch. I'm getting tips. I'm getting tipsy as F. I'm getting, right? My wife, she's on her couch. We bought our couches 6 years ago, matching. Her couch is pristine. It's pristine? What is it? I don't know about nothing. It's gorgeous. Her couch is awesome. Like, she could return her couch today and get a full refund. I'm serious. My couch looks like a homeless man was murdered on it, okay? There are people doing heroin behind my couch. I'm like, get out of here, come on. She's over here, and this is what happens to you when you get to be a grown-up, okay? She's over here. She's freezing. She's her top half is covered up in her Hello Kitty Snuggie. Whatever that dumb thing. I didn't see her buy that. She looks like an old like Hungarian woman selling fruit and stuff. Like, I don't know. Look like E.T. on a milk crate and a BMX bike.
Elliot.
I don't know. What? She, and then that's her top, her bottom half is covered in 19 of her grandmother's Afghans, okay? Just, yeah, and she's still cold. I'm like, you're freezing because those Afghans, I can see your body through them. That's why. I've been meaning to tell you this, but your grandmother's a shitty blanket maker, okay? How about your grandmother not make 60% of a blanket, okay? She made one for the baby. Well, our baby's gonna die of hypothermia, okay? Because your grandmother's garbage at blankets. And that's our date night, and we don't even talk. The only time we talk on our date night, right, grown-ups, is when we're chanting, move that bus, move that bus. That's the only time we talk. You know it. That's true. And we got to get out, because I just had a second child. Yeah, second. Don't you be clapping for it. Shut up. Knock it off. No, you don't get it. No. No. I have a little baby boy, and I already want to fight him. I want to fight him. I know you can't fight a baby. Relax. I know you can't fight a baby, but I want to figure out how. Like, legally, I want to, like, I've thought about it. I'm like, what if we make weight like boxers? You know what I'm saying? Like, if he's 11, and I put garbage bags on and do the paleo diet, and we're the same weight, I can beat the shit out of him legally, because that's Olympic boxing rules, okay? I can fight a kid. If we're both 111 pounds, we can fist fight after school. It's legal. I'll send a note to his teacher. I don't care. Meet your dad at the flagpole at 3 o'clock. His friends are like, why your dad fighting? Something about puking on his shoes 2008 in Easter. I'll do it. I'll fight your ass. This little boy ruined my life since the minute he was born. Don't you? Aw, he's a little crazy idiot, okay? Here's what happened. This is, I'm going to tell you right now. I don't know, but you guys know. Yep, hold on. I'm throwing some science on you right now, some grown man science. My little boy, the first day, he came out C-section. You know what a C-section is? Don't nod your head like you do, because you don't until you... It's not like in the health class where they teach you in the book, and they're like, oh, you make a small incision in the lady, and then the baby comes out on Eagle's wings, and REO Speedwagon is playing. Shit ain't like that, okay? I went into this place in the hospital room. It was like covered like a Dexter kill room in plastic. And, you know what I'm talking about? I was like, oh, what did I thought I got set up, okay? And then the doctor pulls out his spatulas or whatever, like he's making hibachi. I don't know what he's doing. Throwing shrimp in my mouth and eyes. I'm like, oh, that's true. He's like, that's placenta. I'm like, you're a sick doctor. That's... And then he cuts my wife open with his Friday the 13th machete. It's like, yeah! And then he gets inside. He's like, I'll be back in a second. He's 90 seconds in my wife. I'm like, get out of her! Get out of her thorax! Get out of there! And then when the baby finally comes out, the baby, listen, it's gonna get crazy, okay? I'm just saying, if you got pulled pork or nachos and salsa, shit's gonna get real. I'm going all the way with this. This is... Like, all you see first is, it's not the baby's face. It's not like, hi, daddy, this is my face. It's the baby's feet just kicking, and the doctor's trying to get it like a Costa Rican chicken farmer, and just, he's like trying to wrangle it. And it's like a bloody satanic sacrifice. It is. The baby, like, he's pulling it out. Have you ever seen Indiana Jones in the Temple of Doom? Have you ever seen? The doctor is pulling, Kalima Shakti Day. Kalima Shakti Day. Kalima. Yeah, no, it is. And the nurses are in the background. They're like, Madam, Madam, Madasuram, Madasuram. The anesthesiologist is on a drum. He's like, Madasuram, Madasuram. There's an Indian in the background throwing chicken bones at, hey, I don't know. That was my HMO. I don't know about you guys, okay? I would have been better off having my baby behind my heroin couch, to be honest with you. Hey, that's all my time. Thanks very much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Ashley Austin Morris is taking the stage when we return.
You've seen this next lady on the great show, Ugly Betty. Please welcome Miss Austin Ashley Morris.
Hello. Hi. Hi. How you guys doing? Good, good. I'm excited. I'm feeling good. I'm wearing my lucky training bra. It's good. Double A's, baby. Double A's. I like having double A's because I was a really bad student. These are the only A's I've ever had. Straight A's. Valedictorian titties right here. My mom has a bumper sticker. My daughter's an idiot, but her tits made the honor roll. There's some summa cum laude dotted pina colada titties right here. You know what it is? I realize I'm not sexy. I'm accessible. to bald guys named Bill with glaucoma. Because he knows he's not getting with Jennifer Aniston, but he has a shot at me. I mean, not an accurate shot, glaucoma, but a shot. Some women, though, are too sexy. Like, they're trying to be so sexy, they don't even look like women anymore. They just look like aliens from another planet. They're, like, from planet booby, hair extension, puffy lip, you know? And, like, they've been sent to Earth to punish us for facial mobility. And they hoard all the men with jobs. And they're always on their way to Pinkberry. Do you know what I'm talking about? And then I show up, you know, looking like Punky Brewster on crystal meth. And they make me say bad things about them to myself. I'm like, she can't read. Well, she doesn't listen to NPR. I listen to NPR, all right? She doesn't know that guy's name is Tavis, Smiley, not Travis, all right? It's Tavis. You didn't know that, puffy lip, all right? I did, because I'm a hoarder, too, okay? A hoarder of knowledge. Yeah. Important things, meaningful things, like Chaka Khan's real name, Yvette Marie Stevens. What? That's called a nerd riff right there. That's a nerd riff, because everybody knows the only way to fight an alien is with a nerd. So, yeah. So you see some puffy lip tit coming at you, you just nerd riff her. You'd be like, stop, tit. Did you know the Caesar salad had nothing to do with Caesar? It was invented in Tijuana in the 1920s. Oh, nerd riff. On the end of your shoelace is called an aglet. Nerd riff. What? Oh, I'm full of them. You crack this thing open, Snapple caps. Pour out. And I think nerd riffs are the new sexy. Ladies, trust me, the next time you see like a really hot man coming at you, just nerd riff all over his face. You'd be like, hi, baby. Did you know penguins have an organ in their eye that converts seawater into fresh water? I am single. I don't even date, because any guy that asks me out, I just assume he's a pedophile. But he has candy, so I get in the van. I like candy. My boyfriend hates that joke. He was gonna come tonight, but we couldn't find parking for his van. My family really wants me to get married. My grandma, she called me last week. First of all, she's crazy. She's from Texas. Well, that's redundant. Anyway, so she calls me and she was like, Ashley, why aren't you married? I was like, well, I'm not in love with anyone, Grandma. Love? What's love got to do with it? Okay, Tina Turner. Didn't you love Grandpa when you married him? Love? It was the Depression and he had shoes. She has a point. Listen, we are in some challenging financial times right now. You have shoes? You want? This is my mating dance right here. You want? If you want it, then you should have put a shoe on it. What? It's hard to meet people. I was on the subway. I hate when I'm sitting on the subway next to a grown man playing a video game on his phone. You're a grown man. Why are you playing a video game? It's weird. How about I sit down, whip out my Barbies, start playing with my dream castle? How about that? How about that? Right? But I can't, because when you're a little girl, you endow Barbie with your reality. You're like, oh, Barbie wants a puppy and a princess dress. Now Barbie wants a MetroCard and some health insurance. Barbie loves Ken. Now Barbie wants Ken to look like G.I. Joe and make more money. Okay? Okay? When you're little, Barbie eats cookies. Now Barbie's on a juice cleanse because she eats her feelings. All right? Barbie sucks. Barbie's going to therapy. I was thinking the other day about my debt. I have so much debt. I don't know what happened. It was like I was born and then 15 minutes later I had a bad credit score. I don't know what happened. I don't know what impulse buys I was making, the fallopian tube or uterus or what. I don't know how babies are made. I just know I have bad credit. But whenever I get down about my personal credit, I like to think about the national debt, you know, because it makes my debt look like $40, you know? Like bill collector calls, I'm like, why are you calling me? Why don't you call America? Right? Stupid to even understand our national debt. I think it's like $17.4 trillion. Can you understand the word trillion? Because I can't. You might as well say to me, we are 17.4 unicorn bubblegum sham wow in debt. It is registering the exact same way in my brain. Do you know what a sham wow is? It's a mop or a sponge. I don't know. It's $19.95, and if you call now, you'll get two for the price of one. And I wanted to know, like, how many sham wows can we get for $17.4 trillion? So I did the math. Well, no, first I Googled how many zeros are in a trillion. There's 9. My calculator only held 6. I'm like, this is Obama's problem. I love Obama. I fell in love with Obama for the same reason I always fall in love with men. I thought I could get health insurance out of it. But I do love him, but I think we should have a dictator. I said it. I think we should have a dictator, and I think it should be Oprah. Because Oprah could get us out of debt. Write a check, Oprah. We know you're good for it, right? We know you're good for it. I think Oprah should just conquer us, just roll up on the White House all gangster style with her posse. Like, Dr. Oz, take healthcare, Susie Orman, balance the budget, Maya Angelou, read us a poem while it all goes down. You guys, my name is Ashley Ashmore, thank you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Mitch Vaitel is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
All right. I've known this guy a very long time. He was the best comedian at the Aspen Comedy Festival. And he always brings it, and he's always funny, Mr. Mitch Vaitel.
Thanks, everybody. That's Jim. I think he's gay. My name is Mitch, and I'm a little bit famous. Does anybody know who I am when I walked in? Yeah, I'm so famous. I got recognized on the way in. This girl freaked out. She's like, "Oh my God, I saw you on TV." I was like, "Oh my God, I'm gonna have sex." I don't even just like the sex part. I like everything that leads up to it, too. Like, most guys, they just like the sex part. They're just like, "Give me that sweet pussy, bitch." But not me. I like the tease. Like, when you slide a girl's panties off for the first time. Oh, my God. I like it so much. I put them right back on, and I slide them off again. Yeah. I'll do that like 5 or 6 times until the girl wakes up, and it is so worth the try. I just love panties. Panties make me happy. No, nobody hates panties. Nobody's ever like, "Yeah, fucking panties." That's the problem with the kids today, is with their older panties. That's why I love living with a girl. I did not know this, but when you live with a girl, they have a special drawer that is designated just for the panties. It's just a drawer of femininity. Every time you pass, you're like, "That's the panty drawer." That's where it all goes down. There's not a guy in here who has not gone face diving in his girl's panty drawer. When she's, you look around, you're like, "Nobody's home. I'm going in." You open it up, fairy dust goes everywhere. Like, "Ooh, hello, leopard-like G-string, how are you? Have you met crotchless lace with bows? Uh-oh, here comes mean old once-a-month cotton panties. You stay away from her. She's a meanie. She's been through many battles. Her heart is cold. You stay away. Stay away from that side of the drawer." Thanks. That's so funny. I'm having such a good year. This is the best year of my life. I just got married. Everybody, yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. She put a ring on it, bitches. I have a wife. It's so weird saying wife, because for so long, she was just my escort. So it's like, thank you, Craigslist. She's so hot. My wife is really, her name is Jessica, and she's Latina, and she's hot, and she has a very big ass. And I like, yeah, and I like to touch it and squeeze it and have sex with it. It's so much fun. I like doggy style. That's my favorite. But do me a favor, ladies, when we're having sex with you doggy style, pull your own hair, please. I want to enjoy myself. My wife's like, "Pull my hair, grab my hips, slap my ass." I'm like, "Do you want me to vacuum while I'm back here? I could vacuum if you'd like, because this is more chores than I've had since I was 12 years old. Why don't you send me back a list of all the shit I need to accomplish in the 2.5 minutes I'm going to be back here, and I will check them off as I complete them, and maybe if I get all 10, I could win a pizza pie." It's called incentive. My, My wife, she's sexy, and when she knows when we have sex, I like when she keeps her shoes on. That's hot. Girls, keep your shoes on while we're having... There is nothing hotter in the world than having sex with a girl who keeps her shoes on. I don't even know why. I think it's because afterwards they can just leave, but it's still so... I don't know psychology. I don't know the psychology of it, but it turns me on. That's a bad joke. I knew I was going to marry Jessica the first day I met her. We just had that connection. Yeah, we had that connection. And we did everything wrong as a couple that you're not... We had sex on the first date. You're not supposed to do that. But we couldn't help it. We were just out to dinner, and like halfway through dinner, I started to get that feeling like we are definitely going to have sex later, because she had gone to the bathroom and left her drink with me. So I was like, yeah. I was like, this shit's going down. Sometimes things are bigger than you and you just go with it. We didn't really go all the way. She just gave me oral sex, which she's like, don't tell the audience that. They're going to think I'm a whore. And I was like, you know, honey, you are. But you're my whore. You're my whore. And that's all that's important. As long as you're... I think it's cool for a girl to be a whore, just as long as she's one guy's whore. Yeah. And as long as she makes the choice to do it. If a guy asks a girl for oral sex on the first date, he's just a dick. But if a girl offers it because she wants to reward him because he was nice, I think that's kind of sweet. Yeah. It's kind of the guy version of getting roses on a first date. Like, oh my God, I didn't expect this. You're such a sweetie. Oh, what a mush. I gotta take a picture and show my friends. I wanna... Jessica said that she did it because she loves doing it. That's hard to find, a girl that loves doing it. She told me on the first day, she's like, I love doing this. And I told my friends, I'm like, I'm gonna marry this girl. She loves giving oral sex. And they're like, dude, you are so naive. Every girl says that they love giving oral sex until you marry them, and then they never do it again. It's a scam, and I saw it on Dateline. But we've been married for 6 months today, and she does it more than ever, so they were wrong. I have, however, noticed that the execution of the act has changed a little bit. In the old days, when the act was completed, how do I put this delicately? There was no evidence a crime had been committed. The scene was left pristine, but when she's done now, it's CSI up in there. There is DNA contamination. A terrible crime has been committed, and my belly is the victim. It is not a pretty sight. Thank you very much for watching my show, everybody. Thank you. I'm supposed to stay here now.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Dean Edwards is taking the stage when we return.
All right, you've seen him on MTV and the Geico, but most of all, he's an SNL alum like myself and one of my favorites, Mr. Dean Edwards.
What's up, what up? Clap it up, man, clap it up! Yeah!
What's going on?
Now stop it. That's enough, I ain't got a lot of time, shoot. It's summertime in here. You know, it's funny, like, I'm glad they're doing this now, because I was here a couple of months ago when they first started doing it. It was freezing out. But now it's hot, man, like next level. We had 100 degrees for 2.5 weeks. Let me explain something. By 2 or 3 days in 100 degree weather, I realized I am African American, right? Like, I'm not pure blood African. I'm a watered down strain of African. Cause I can't deal, like, my people must be from the shaded part of Africa or something, son. You know what I mean? Like, you ever walk outside, you feel like you stepped into slavery? That's how I felt. All the every time my wife's like, baby, let's go. I was like, swing low, sweet care. Why am I limping? And that's how I know I'm getting older, because I'm starting to complain like that now. And plus, I also know I'm getting older because I'm starting to complain about music. Like, look, I love rap, I love hip hop, but I don't relate anymore. Look, I appreciate Lil Wayne, but we have different perspectives. You know what I mean? First of all, I'm annoyed that as a grown man, I have to call another grown man Lil anything, right? Like, can't we graduate just your Wayne now, dog? You know what I mean? And then I like my clothes to fit a certain, I like baggy. Lil Wayne wears skinny jeans. Like, when did we allow that? Why are men wearing skinny jeans? Like, do women like guys in skinny jeans? Is that, honestly, like, honestly, fellas, if you wear skinny jeans, die. And I mean that, because I don't understand how you can be a man approaching a woman and you have camel toe too. You're like, hey, what's up, who's poppin'? How you doing?
Yes, yeah, you see, I got it? Yeah, I'm matching. Yes, I do. Yes, I do have a yeast infection right now. Yes, I...
And I actually met Lil Wayne at JFK Airport. I was flying overseas, and I was flattered because he recognized me from Guide Code, right? But it hit me while he was talking to me. If there's no music playing, I don't know what he's saying, right? Because Lil Wayne has a very distinctive voice. You know what I mean? You know when you get hunger pains, your stomach starts to growl? That's Lil Wayne's voice, right? You know you get the...
Yeah, buddy.
Hey, yo. He was in full-on conversation. He's like, yo, my man, yo, use the red funny dude. I love. I was looking for subtitles to slow down, dog. I just want to keep up, right? But it's funny because I was flying overseas. I was actually going to the Middle East, to Dubai, man. And for some odd reason, they were flying me through Moscow, right? We connected through Moscow. Let me ask, have any of you ever walked into a room and you're the only person that looks like you, right? Imagine that for an entire country, right? Because look, I'm not gonna lie, boarding the flight, I expected I might be the only person that was black sitting in first class. But nah, that was it for the plane, right? Like, the only thing blacker than me was luggage, right? And what's interesting about Russian people is when you're boarding a flight, like in the States, if I wanna talk about somebody, I'm gonna at least do it I'm like, yo, look at this dude right here, look at you. Every Russian that boarded this plane had no problem letting me know they didn't expect to see my black self sitting there either, right? They literally stopped. They're like, oh, but this is good. The pilot stuck his head. I was like, there was a little girl saying, how you sound like her? And I expected it would die down. You know, we figured like, okay, after 34 minutes, it died down. 4 hours later, they still. And finally I said, you know, let me pay no mind. I'm gonna watch a movie. So I put on a headset. I started watching that movie, Taken, which was weird because every time I took my headphones off, I felt like I was in the movie Taken, right? And Russian, you know, it's funny, if you hear it long enough, Russian sounds like English in reverse. Almost, you know what it sounds like? It sounds like the theme song to the Grinch That Stole Christmas played back as, you know, you're the mean one, Mr. Grinch, you're rotten to the core. Oh,
And it continued, and no one defended me. One person came to my rescue. There was an old dude sitting across the aisle. Old dude looked like Gandalf, right? And he said, don't worry. And then he looked back at everyone, went off. He's like, that's it. And I was flattered because I ain't never had a wizard defend me, you know? But then he turned back and looked at everyone like, this is Kobe Bryant. I was like, no. No. But that's what I get, because I don't speak the language. I couldn't even really, after I thought about it, I said, well, I can't be mad about it. Shoot, I don't speak the language. And I know sometimes people are like, well, you go overseas and learn another language. Nah, dog, that ain't. I'm a comedian. I work 15 minutes a night. You really think I feel like sitting through 12 CDs of some chick named Rosetta trying to explain it? Here's what you do. You go to another country, here's what you do. Don't learn how to say hello, goodbye. Learn how to say, that's funny. That's when, learn how to say that's funny, because if nothing else, when people start talking about you, you can confuse them, you know what I mean? Like I learned later on, the way to say, oh, funny, oh, funny in Russian is, kok smezhno, kok smezhno, kok. So when I, sure enough, when I was flying back in, I got on the plane, sure enough, like, hey, kok smezhno, they're like, Kobe Bryant is smart. He's very smart. Yo, you know what? Before I go, we ending this mine a little differently. Jim's a good friend of mine. Jim, come out up on stage. We're gonna do a bit, man. Let's have some fun. All right. You set it up. You set it up.
All right. There's a lot of things you don't know about Dean, but he's also like a master of voices. So here's Brian Johnson of AC/DC.
Right, okay.
If he had a talk show, right?
Okay.
You pick whoever you want.
Okay, all right.
Welcome to the Brian Johnson talk show. Now today we have a great guest for you. He comes to us from the land of the USA. And he's a great actor. Please welcome him. I'm not sure he is, but it's a surprise. Here he comes. Who we got here?
You know this is Denzel Washington and yeah. And hold on. I brought a friend of mine along, Tracy Morgan. Tracy, hey, what's going on, man? How you doing? What's popping?
Hold on, we got some actors that like to talk to you.
Yeah,
hey, listen, I'm Joe Pesci. How come we... Hey, listen.
Pesci.
How come we never did no movies together?
I'm saying you never come to the projects. Why don't you come? If you came to the projects, we can rock it out. Denzel. Well, you know what, Joe? It's funny that you would say that because I've been waiting to do something with you for all the people here. Yeah. Good.
Yeah. He worked. See, that's another thing. We both were Tracy Morgan.
Yeah.
I thought I was the only guy who knew Tracy.
Yeah, no.
Until I said, we Tracy Morgan.
You gotta get in that head. You gotta get in that head. If you wanna do Tracy now, I see a lot of white women in here. We can make mixed babies. We can make the little mixed babies with the good hair. Name of Maya. All I'm saying is when I hear you doing Tracy Morgan, when I'm doing Trump, when I look at this crowd, somebody gonna get pregnant. Y'all get them pregnant, Papa. I'm saying you gonna get them pregnant. Make sure when you get them pregnant, you make sure you gotta leave it in there. Let it marinate. You gotta let that marinate. Get the juices in there.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think there you have it. We got Tracy Morgan, Denzel Washington, and thank you for listening to the Brian Johnson Talk Show.
We appreciate it.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Yeah. Do we have a good time tonight? Yeah. We had a great time tonight. It's the best city in the world. And you got to tell people about Access TV and the comedy that's going on. One of the greatest things to see ever is live comedy. And when you're in New York, yes, that's right. Because you never know exactly what you're getting. You just don't know what you're getting. You just don't know. We saw a lot of Tracy Morgan tonight. Tracy Morgan was in Australia. He did an Australia tour. I don't know if you knew that. Doesn't matter. Where are you from again? What was the city? I got to remember this. Oogly Woogly Wood? Walla Walla. Yeah, Woogla Woogla. All right. We'll see you in Woogla Woogla. I like to bring up all the great comedians. What a great show. Perhaps one of the best I've seen in a long time. Please, Aaron and Ashley and Dean and Mitch. Thank you all so much for coming out.